The H1N1 outbreak that started in 2009 and wound down 10 months later was Singapore's last major infectious disease emergency. Now, here's how it panned out. So the World Health Organization first declared the H1N1 infection a public health emergency in April that year after discovering a new virus strain in the US about a month earlier. In Singapore, the health ministry took precautionary measures to prepare against the H1N1 outbreak. This included raising an existing disease surveillance system and influenza pandemic preparedness plan called Disease Outbreak Response System, from green to yellow. And when WHO raised its pandemic alert from phase 4 to phase 5 due to the increasing human-to-human spread, Singapore's MOH raised its alert from yellow to orange the same day. MOH then revised the DOORS alert downwards to yellow on 11 May. And at that time, there were no confirmed cases of infection here. The first case of H1N1 in Singapore emerged some 2 weeks later. The patient, a 22-year-old undergraduate who returned from New York on 26 of May. She developed a cough while on the flight, but passed the airport's temperature screening as she did not have a fever. The infection was confirmed by laboratory results that evening, and MOH initiated contact tracing of her close contacts and various measures. Now, as of 23rd June, there were 194 human cases of H1N1 in Singapore. On 18 July, the H1N1 virus claimed its first victim in Singapore, a 49-year-old man with heart problems. He died of a heart attack, which was complicated by severe pneumonia and the H1N1 infection. The virus outbreak appears to peak by August, with attendances at clinics dropping for the first time in weeks. More than 400 family clinics island-wide were made H1N1 ready with various medical supplies, including personal protection equipment and Tamiflu vaccines made available at these pandemic preparedness clinics. The 18th and last H1N1 fatality of the year was in September, a 61-year-old man with a history of diabetes, hypertension and end-stage renal failure. The DOORS alert was lowered from yellow to green on 12 February 2010. And by this time, some 415,000 people island-wide had been infected with the virus, with most said to experience mild illness.